whole staff. He's about to open a real can of whoop ass on your whole team. He's out there.
I wonder if there are people who fight better on skates, right? Because here's the thing. At the beer league level, the guy that wins the fight is often the better skater, you know, because that guy's more stable. Oh, yeah. And a lot of fighting has to do with throwing the other guy off balance in a hockey fight. But at, like, the pro level, they're all good skaters. I don't think anyone loses fights because they get pushed around too easily. They live their life on skates. Are there people who are, like, I swear, you'd be way more badass at the beer league level if you had grippy cleats. You know, you'd just be so solid. That other guy would be a toy for you to toss around.
Yeah, you'd want a pair of, if you were the fighter, the guy who may be ready to come off the bench, you'd want two pieces of footwear, a pair of skates for sure, and then a pair of steel cleats. For if you've got to storm the fucking ice, right? If you
had like those old bottoms.
Yeah, the old timey steel cleats that were more like thumbtacks on the bottom than the new new baseball cleats are a bunch of blades, dull blades, basically, and different
that's
angles.
That's risky business, doing it with the cleats, though, because if you're up against me in a beer league, you're going to beat my ass. But if you're up against a real professional hockey fighter, what he's going to do is he's going to grab right here on your jersey, and he's going to use his professional NHL legs to skate backwards really quick. Yeah. You're going to fall, and then he's going to do the thing that you'll see in hockey fights where they grab and they push you back, and then they pull their hand back and bump, bump, and they punch you like that. And that's exactly what would happen.
I was going to say that. I know I'm the least knowledgeable, but I definitely am aware and have seen the technique of the hockey fight. It's a whole different kind of combat, and the rules are very different from a lot of other kinds of combat because of the ice, the skates, the pads, the loose jerseys, the helmets that may or may not be on. There's a lot of variables that aren't there in regular combat.
I guess in grappling, sometimes grabbing the clothes is a big deal. Like,
there's a little gi work in there, right?
Yeah,
like,
gi work is essential in hockey. Yeah, just the way that controlling the other guy is 2/3 of the fight.
I just imagine choking a guy out with his own jersey. Just get behind him.
I love all the shit talking like videos because they're all Canadian. Like when like the real fighter goes up against the guy who like kind of got conscripted into the fight, you know, because like if someone does something shitty to you, to a teammate, it's your duty to go over and fight him. And oftentimes the bruiser will do something shitty and the closest guy is like a 20-year-old rookie who's like, oh, Jesus. So he has to skate over there and start getting in a fight with him. And immediately there's one clip of the big bruiser guy coming in. He's like, oh, yeah, which shoulder do you want? Left, right? Which one do you prefer, huh? You know, because you always grab the other person's shoulder there. And he was, like, offering, like, which one do you want? I'll let you pick. You know, it's going to go great for you, I promise. You know, like,
I would grab their left. I would always grab their left, right? I'd want that crossover. And I feel like this arm can then really, like, first of all, I feel like I control their left arm completely now. They're not going to be able to come up and over with that. And I feel like their right arm has to come over my right arm now. And I just feel like I could, if I pull them this way, then they're turning away from me, and I could pull.